This week on the Experimental Aircraft Channel, we drop in on the Rotorway Gathering in Lake City, Florida, and get to know the community.
We've mentored a lot of new people. A lot of new people have got their start.
So Bob, introduce yourself here and explain why it is that you do this thing yearly for the Rotorway community.
Well, I did this for a living. I did this for 37 years for the government and for the Navy. Been all over the world doing aviation, especially structures. And when I retired, believe it or not, I thought I was going to be bored. I even applied for a job at a local aircraft company. And luckily for me, I decided to go to Oshkosh, and I got involved with Rotorway. A friend of mine in the motorhome with me said, "Hey, look, this is a good deal on a helicopter. Would you like to get a helicopter now?" And I says, "Well, I haven't really thought of it, you know, because I had just retired." And one thing led to another. I bought the helicopter. I started working on it. And I started realizing all the things that I got shorted on. It was an older helicopter. I didn't realize it because it was a well-built helicopter. It was just old. And then I had a bad landing. And then I decided it, you know, in for a penny, in for a pound. And I went crazy. I started rebuilding everything on it. Well, when I got done with the build, I had a choice. I could either sell the helicopter and buy another kit and build it, or I could mentor other people. And I really wasn't interested in building another helicopter. I was more interested in mentoring, because that's kind of what I did as a supervisor. I mentored new hires and even journeymen working on military jets. So I started out with one guy, and we started working on his helicopter, and it was enjoyable. I liked working with the guy. I had as much a thrill when he hovered it for the first time as I did with mine. And then I started doing two guys at the same time. I even bought another hangar, because I needed more room. I ran out of room, so I bought another hangar. And then this guy, Homer Bell, up in Ohio, he used to have an annual fly-in at the farm. He called it the Bean Patch. And I went there a few times. Homer's my age, same age, different background, but same age. And he was going to start semi-retiring, because at the farm he had to do a lot of prep. He didn't live at an air park, so he had to do mowing. He had to give up some of his bean crop. His barn was not really set up for a lot of aviation work like mine was. So I decided to make an attempt and start it up. When I started, you know, and that was, God, 10 years ago, 15 years ago. When I started, I originally had, the first time I did the fly-in was maybe five people plus Mark Peterson, and I put it right before Sun and Fun with the idea that people on the way to Chopper Town would stop by here, because we're right en route. We're right at the intersection of I-10 and I-75, so it worked out really well for people that were traveling to Sun and Fun. And then every year it got bigger. One thing led to another. Then I started getting requests to do it twice a year, once in spring, once in fall. And our weather here in Florida is conducive to that, whereas April and October is winter time for a lot of members. And it just started growing and growing and growing. And this particular one, we had 30 ships, and we had about 75 people come. The results are very good. Now Mark still comes, Orv still comes, Homer still comes. We've mentored a lot of new people. A lot of new people have got their start from the gathering. They came to the gathering out of curiosity, and they left with cards and addresses of other people in their area. And the next gathering, they were proud owners or builders.
Thank you. Hey guys, one second. Hey guys, you've probably seen me traveling a whole lot these days. What makes all this possible, getting this original aviation content, is sponsors like these.
Dynon Avionics at dynonavionics.com. Airtech Coatings at airtechcoatings.com. Airworx at airworxaviation.com. AviNation at avinationusa.com. Check the description below for links to these great companies. And visit our website at experimentalaircraftchannel.com for events, our video library arranged in easy-to-find playlists on specific topics, affiliate products, aviation merchandise, and so much more. If you like these videos that we are producing weekly, give that like button a click and engage all notifications so you don't miss a single episode.
And so I plan to continue it as long as I'm capable. I'm not young. I'm trying to get some younger people interested. We have a guy in Texas, Jim Hardy. He's somewhat younger than me. Unfortunately, he still works. Well, unfortunate for us, not unfortunate for him. But he owns a property down there, and he owns his own grass strip, and he's just starting out. And when he did his in April, he had maybe seven ships showed up, and it's a good start. That's how I started. And hopefully within the next couple of years, he'll develop his, and then I'll be able to retire once again.
Well, I appreciate you opening up your home, hangar, and part of the air park to share this with the community, and that you're helping grow in aviation.
Well, that's what I'm trying to do. That's the goal.
This really is a great community. And if you'd like to learn more about the Rotorway Helicopter, Rotor X Aircraft is now supplying and preserving the Rotorway Helicopter legacy and providing new kits. Check out rotorxaircraft.com. And if you'd like to follow Bob and his future Rotorway gatherings, check out his website at rotorway-rework.com. Thanks for watching this week's episode. Remember to like, subscribe, hit the bell for all notifications so you don't miss a single episode. Thanks for watching.